Okay, so after work, I go to, you know, put something in the passenger seat after work and drive home. Walk up to the car and nothing. Okay, so I'd guess that it'd be a case of taking off the window crank handle, the door opener, the door handle, undoing these screws along the bottom, and just lifting it up. I've watched a few videos. Apparently you have to be careful when you undo this door opener, just to get the plastic tab off the wire or the rod running along to the door lock here. Otherwise you've got to buy a new handle. Now apparently from what I've seen is a tab or a metal clip just behind the handle, in between the handle and this white plastic washer. The window should be up before you remove the handle, so that it clears the glass from this area here that you need to work on. Okay, so it's been taken off before. This car's, what is it? It's a 1995, so it's exactly 20 years old. Okay, so I'll just do a bit of filming of the door in case somebody's looking for some other information. That's your armrest or the handle. That's your door opener. Okay, so you've got two screws, one on the top, one on the bottom there, like a T-piece. Put your handle. And back here there's a spring. And the rod runs from the back here. Okay. Attachment is behind this this assembly here, so I'd say to find out what sort of clip arrangement there is, you just undo the screws, turn it around, and have a look at the back, because that's where the handle will be connected to the rod. All right, put it from the opposite direction. That's the crank handle to put the window up and down. It's just on a spline, and just sort of sits through there, through the opening, and there's two bolts there. Right, there's a lock through there. That's it there. Okay, so you can probably see there that the rod from the lock to the door latch has fallen off. There's the plastic bit there, and the rod's not connected to it, so I'll try and connect the rod and it might fix it. I don't know. Okay, so there's the rod just there, and that goes into that cup there, and it slots in that hole there. Okay, so I've got some silicone. I'm just going to put some onto that yellow bracket there. Okay, so I've got silicone on that, and you may be able to see that that yellow tab just there. I've got to try and hook that, bring that onto the there. Done it. Okey-doke. Okay, some important information about putting silicone on that that yellow plastic holder there. Don't actually put it up the top here. Don't put it up there where the rod goes into the plastic holder. Only put it around here. If you put it here, as you can see, when you turn the key, it moves. It's got to move that little bit, and that'll restrict the movement. So only lock it in if you're going to use builder's glue or silicone. It's your choice, but I would only apply the glue or silicone just there down the bottom. So now I'll turn the key, and probably be able to see the machinations of how it all works. Thank you. Okay, sorry about the lengthy video, but it may be of some use to somebody. So this is the interior locking mechanism. Yeah, okay, so that's it for today. Today's a Saturday, and tomorrow morning is Sunday morning, and I'll just come around and check that this is, you know, not gunked up with any silicon, but it's going to move freely up the top there. I'll put a bit of extra silicon around the bottom there to lock it all in, and I'll reassemble it, and I'll film that. It's around about the 15th of the 7th, 2015. So we're looking on the inside of the door cover. There's just these small plastic holders, and they're where the screws go through down the bottom of the cover. Along the top there's just this draft seal. So yeah, it's the next day, and you know, it all works well. It's not binding on that silicon. So I just put a dob of silicon here, and put it all together. Okay, so that's it. How to repair a lock and take off the inside door panel. Hope it helps out.